Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. This is Eileen with Unique Gifts and Decor by Lady Di. Happy Thursday to everyone. You guys, I'm hoping you guys have enjoying your day today. I am enjoying mine. It's Thursday, you guys. It has been a short week, seems like, and I mean the time has flown by. I know Tuesday I ended up doing that haul from the Dollar General. And then yesterday, y'all, to be honest, I didn't do anything useful. I mean, I had a couple of meeting conference calls, but work-wise or design-wise, I was lazy yesterday. So kind of want to make up for today. I did have two orders came in yesterday evening. So I am trying to get those out today because I believe they're going to come by and pick them up later on this evening. But I want to make sure I have everything done. And out and ready to go. But other than that, you guys, it has been a wonderful day. The sun is shining down here today in North Carolina. We were supposed to expecting some rain. Now, it rained for the last, it rained Wednesday, Tuesday. It rained pretty much off and on yesterday as well. Last night, it did a little bit. But today, it was supposed to rain, but it did. I don't think it rained today, you guys, at all, which is a good thing. Sun is shining. It's not hot, nor is it cold. I mean, fall is right around the corner, so it's been a pretty good day. It's probably a good day to do some yard work, but y'all, I don't feel like it. I know. I have been spoiled this summer, you guys, because it's been so hot. I just really hadn't been into doing any yard work, but I know I've got to do something because fall's here. I got to get my mom's planted out in my yard. You know, just kind of get some things ready for the fall season. Definitely got to redo my grass seeds and all that good stuff. So, yeah, I got a lot to do. But nevertheless, it might be done tomorrow or Saturday because I think they're expecting some rain next week. So, I kind of want to get some things going. But other than that, you guys, I want to show you guys this custom order that I got yesterday, and I'm going to use some of the items that they requested, as well as add some of my items in my stockpile as well. So I'm going to use these totes. These totes, you guys, we got from the Family Dollar early part of this summer, I believe. It came in the blue as well as the brown. So I'm going to use the blue or the brown one here. Now, as you can see, these are really flimsy. So what you would need to do if you decide to use some of these, you definitely want to make it sturdy. I got a fly in here, you guys. You definitely want to make it sturdy. You want to add some cardboard at the bottom and on the sides because, again, you can see how flimsy it is. And you don't want your items, once you put it in there in your basket, it's going to sink like that. You don't want that to happen. So what I did do here, I ended up putting the cardboard on the sides and the bottom, and I ended up putting the contract paper on top, as well as the tissue paper. Now, I did use some of this natural shred. You can get it in a big bag like this from World Market. I use some of those in those flat concepts, so I've got another bag and that one left. So let's just assemble this right quick today. So this is one of the placemats and it's really sturdy. It's the wicker one. I got this from this one of those stores that was remodeling. So I got a few of those and it's very sturdy. So I'm gonna use it as a backer. Now some of the items that my customer wanted, she's doing a basket for her aunt. So these are the items that she gave me to put in here. So we've got some tequila here. And she bought these, y'all. Y'all know how I gave y'all my experience at the liquor store, which that's not the place where I really patron. So anyway, she gave me two of these. So I think she knew because we've had that conversation and she was laughing at me when I told her I had that other custom basket that I did. I was looking for some Crown Royal apple. I was like, I don't know what this stuff is. But anyway, so I ended up, she ended up getting the items for me, which I'm thankful because I didn't plan on going to the liquor store. Not where I even go. So she also gave me some of this Generate wait a minute, Girardin, excuse me, syrup. So she gave me two of these. So we're just going to put both of them on that side there. Now I've got some, I don't want it to tip over. As you all can see, it is a little heavy. So we're going to take some tape and kind of put around here so these four items will kind of have a little, stay together a little bit. She also gave me some of this pineapple mango dual juices. So I've got two cases of those right here. And we're going to just add these to this here. Oh, wow. And I've got to put some of my shred on this side so that can fill in there. Okay, so those are, oh, she definitely gave me some of these cigars. So we're going to take these cigars to the, the backer. So those were the items that she gave me for her aunt's basket. So she said her aunt likes neutral colors. So what I did add some of my items in here to kind of make it a little personable instead of alcoholic. So I got this crossover bag that I got from Temu. I think I have a couple of these left, so I'm going to add that one here. She says she likes the earth tone colors, so that's what I'm kind of going with that design as well. I've got some of these bath salts. We got, it's the Honey Sunflower brand from the Dollar Tree. It also has the body wash as well, so we're going to add that here. And I'm going to add some tape so that these won't shift. Also got the bubble bath here. So I think it's a 4-piece set. It might have the lotion too, but I didn't have that in my stockpile, and I'm trying to use all what I have before I go out and purchase anything new. Let's see. So I've got this Yardley Shea Buttermilk Soap. And I want to put that there. This is the loofah that we got from the Dollar Tree. And I've got one of my flowers that I'm going to embellish it with right here. So y'all, this is a very easy concept to put together right quick. Again, she only said her aunt liked the earth tone color, so we're going to try to, even though all this side is alcoholic, well, you know, it is what it is, y'all. And this is kind of the personal part that I am doing for her. So what I am going to do is cello wrap this. So I've already cut my cello wrap down. And I'm going to move this up a little bit so we can get this wrap. Temporary tie this here until I do the sides. It's even on both sides. and it is, I don't usually do any alcohol baskets unless it's a special request. Here in North Carolina, we cannot sell alcohol on the streets. So that is a great big no-no. We can do the sparkling cider, but the alcohol, and I wouldn't want to sell that on the street anyway, you know, unless somebody wants a custom ordered, they would have to meet me with the items, because, you know, you just never know if there's any undercover officers, you know, out there. You just never know. You don't never want to put yourself in that type of situation. I know a lot of people used to ask about selling alcohol on the streets. Some cities do allow that. Some states do, some don't. But I would not advise you putting yourself in a position to do it, even though you know it's not allowed. And then you're going to have to end up paying a fine. And you just don't want to do that. If you're starting out your business and everything, you got a legit business with your name and everything, you just don't want to do nothing that's going to mess up your credibility. If somebody really wants some alcohol in there, they can bring it to your house and you can assemble it that way, or, you know, find another avenue. But don't put yourself in a position where you're putting your business in jeopardy over some alcohol. That's just not being a wise steward, okay? So this is the bow that I did, the bow that I got the ribbon from Sam's. And I kind of just put two bows in one using my Bowdabra. As you all know, I use that. So here is the final product here, you guys. I think it turned out very well. Again, by her furnishing all the alcohol and the juices and everything to make the drinks, mixed drinks or whatever it is. I don't really know because I don't drink. But I did add my personal touch over here. She can have the alcohol and whatever she want to do on her birthday, but she's also getting some personal items as well. So let me know what you guys think about this gift. I think it turned out very well. Custom orders, you know, you can't go wrong. If they furnish you the majority items, you just put your twist on it and add your personal items, and you're good to go. So thank you for watching this video. Please like, share, comment. Till the next video, you all be blessed. Bye-bye.